an essential ingredient to maintaining life as we know it. Imagine waking up one morning and you walk to your bathroom sink, you turn on the tap, and nothing comes out. No water. You see, living here in the United States, it's hard for our minds to wrap around this seemingly improbable situation. Water scarcity and water pollution seem like distant problems that only developing nations face. But this simply isn't true. According to the United Nations, nearly 1.2 billion people lack access to safe drinking water simply because of the unequal distribution, pollution, and management of this vital resource. And so I'm here standing in front of you today to tell you about why we should care about this resource and preserve this resource for the future. And I came to realize the vitality of water in my 2012 trip to India, where I was able to visit with family members in Kerala. And I was able to travel around the state, and one such place that I visited was Alappuzha, Kerala. And my family and I got to take a houseboat tour along the Alappi Riverway, which you see behind us. And I saw many things and learned many things through this trip. For one, I learned that people in developing nations are extremely resourceful and rely on nature to provide them with the products that they use in their daily life. Here in the United States, we have everything become prepackaged, ready to use, and we aren't as reliant on nature's resources. But that simply isn't the case in developing nations. And so here you can see a lady who's actually taking that pile of coconut husk hair that we're standing in front of in the bottom picture and turning it into rope that she's going to use later on. And furthermore, on the houseboat tour that I was taking, I was able to actually see how water pollution can impact the livelihoods of people that live around the water. In India, there's lush green vegetation that grows in the surface of the water, and the government uses chemical and manual means to remove this vegetation simply because it hinders with the transportation of goods, the fishing industry, and it actually has a negative impact on the livelihoods of people that live around this waterway. For example, this family that you see here, that water source, the Alappi Riverway, is actually their water source in cleaning dishes, washing clothes, and even drinking water. And so that got me to thinking about how chemicals leaching into water and heavy metals being present in water is a serious issue that many water filters can't fix. And so what I learned from my trip were two main things. First, that the state of our water sources play an important part in our daily lives, and that water pollution is a global problem. It's not something that developing countries face, but in fact, we even have the problem in our own backyard. If we take a look at the state of our Jordan River, it's beautiful in some areas, but some areas are seemingly so polluted. In fact, in my science experiment, I was able to collect brackish water samples from the Jordan River to test because it had an extremely low pH and a really high arsenic concentration. So this shows you that water pollution is something that all of us can care about, and all of us have the power to impact. And second, that water scarcity is a growing problem. 1.2 billion people currently do not have access to water, but according to the United Nations, in the coming years, nearly 500 more people are going to be added into that 1.2 billion number, just because we aren't managing this vital resource of water properly. And so that kind of got me into thinking of what I can do to come up with a solution to filtering water so that I can grant access to people that don't have access to clean, safe drinking water. And so I looked at a study that was conducted by the Institute of Hazard Risk and Resilience, and I found that arsenic concentration in sample tube wells all over India and Bangladesh were actually far exceeding World Health Organization permissible limits, meaning that this was an issue that had severe health implications. Through the prolonged exposure of arsenic in drinking water, you develop a symptom known as arsenicosis, which is pretty much the callousing of your hands and the soles of your feet, which makes it really painful for you to walk and complete daily activities, and could potentially lead to cancer. And so the problem that I identified in my science fair project was that filtration systems and the status quo fail to remove both microbiological organisms like E. coli and fecal chloroform and heavy metal contaminants. So a potential filtration system that I had to create should be able to remove both microbiological organisms and heavy metal contaminants. And in my science fair project, I collected water from the Jordan River, specifically the Midvale Slag Superfund site, and it had an abundance of fecal chloroform and arsenate, which allowed me to test my results more accurately. And so now you're probably thinking, what was this filtration system that I created? So the filtration system that I created had a filter medium that used terracotta pots. And I chose this for two main reasons. First, it's easy to manufacture and can be locally produced in places like India, Africa, because they have an abundance of clay. And second, the burnout material that you can use to make the clay pots can be used from anything from newspaper shreddings, coffee grounds, or even coconut husks. So it's geographically feasible to be implemented. And then, to remove the bacteria found in water, I decided to use colloidal silver. So like you see these people doing, colloidal silver would be put on the exterior and the interior of these terracotta pots. And that was how I would remove the antibacterial agent. And then to remove the heavy metal, which was arsenic in my science fair project, I decided to use iron sulfate, which is a flocculating agent. So if you see this diagram here, you see how when I add this powder into the water, it forms a bridge trapping these arsenate particles and forms flocs that sedimentize. And that way, I can filter clean water that is free from microbiological organisms and heavy metals. So this is how the final prototype looks like. It's a, is a terracotta pot laced with colloidal silver that is inserted into a water receptacle. And the thing is, this is extremely eco-friendly, can be locally manufactured and produced, it's easy to use, and costs less than $10.30. So for less than $10.30, this water filtration device has two impacts. First, on the local scale, it can allow us to take action to prompt our local council members to start cleaning up our local water sources, like the Jordan River. And second, on the global scale, if this water filtration system can be implemented in developing nations, it has the potential to reduce mortality rates that are caused from waterborne illnesses by nearly 69 to 72%. So why should you care? Why should you care about preserving this resource that is finite? Water, we all need it, no matter where we are, no matter where we're from. And therefore, I urge all of you to realize the importance that water plays in each of your lives and to start protecting this valuable resource. Thank you.